Okay, guys, so before we move ahead, I'm open for freelance projects. So if you have something that you want me to draw, then just hit me up on Fiverr and we will move ahead from there. So before we begin painting the actual hair, you want to have your colors ready in a palette. So for that, you want to have your base color. Base color is going to be the color of the hair, and then you want to have a slightly dark color, two shades which are slightly darker than the base color, then one black color, like the darkest one of them all, and then slightly lighter color. Now if you are painting lighter hair, then you might not want to pick up black color, you might want to pick up a darker version of the base color. I hope you're getting what I'm trying to say here. Now once you have your palette ready, you want to create a layer, and in this layer we are just creating the basic silhouette of the hair. So it all obviously depends on you. So for that, what I'm doing is I used a soft airbrush and I just, you know, decreased the size of the brush just to create the silhouette of the hair. Now I'm just picking up a slightly darker color of the base color and I'm just filling in the shape with that color, as you can see right here. And for the edges of the hair, I'm just going over the edges really light-handed so that the colors look well blended. Now once you have that, you want to pick up black color, the darkest one of them all, and just create alpha lock on the layer where you shaded the whole silhouette. And mind you, I shaded or filled the shape in with the dark color in a different layer. So you want to create new layer for each step. Now I created alpha lock here and I am just painting the black color over the areas where I think light is not really hitting. All right, so in my mind the light is coming from the left hand side of the object, right? Now once you have that, you're going to create a new layer, and then I'm just using the same soft airbrush and the streamline is up to 25%. Now what you want to do is you want to just decrease the size of the brush, and then you want to pick up the real color. Now what I mean by the real color is the base color of the hair, which is the actual color of the hair. And I am drawing hair like strokes here and there, not here and there, actually I'm filling in the whole shape with those strokes, with those fine strokes. So you want to make sure that you are decreasing the size of the brush. So I'm just going to fill in the whole shape and just speeding it up so that I don't bore you guys. Also, when you're done with the fine hair strokes, you want to create some thicker hair strokes as well, just, you know, here and there. You don't really have to fill the whole thing in with those thick hair strokes. You just want to, you know, add those thick strokes here and there and not everywhere. Okay guys, so now once you're happy with all of the stroke thing, you just have to create alpha lock on the same layer, and then you want to select a lighter color, the lighter version of the base color, and then you want to put that color over the areas where you think the light is hitting hard. And also then after that, you want to pick up the dark color, and then you want to paint that dark color on the areas where the light is not at all hitting. Now once you are done with that as well, you want to pick up light pen from Luminance brush set, and then you want to decrease the size of the brush. Then you want to pick up, you can either pick up the base color or the slightly darker version of that. It doesn't really matter because light pen makes every color look lighter. So but yeah, you want to make sure you're not picking up black unless you are painting black colored hair. Even though black colored hair are not actually truly black, there are some grays and browns in there. So yeah, keeping that in mind, I'm just painting again the hair strokes. Now the reason why I choose light paint to create the hair strokes is because it makes the hair look finer, if that make any sense. So yeah, I hope you guys can see what I'm doing on the screen, because the hair strokes are too thin. So once you're done with the hair strokes, you want to create highlights, and for that you want to create a new layer, and also you want to use the similar brush, light pen brush. So also you want to make sure the opacity is really high, and to add highlights, just, you know, create some random hair like thingies as I'm doing in the video. I don't know how to explain that, and do that. And once you're happy with that, you want to pick blending brush and make sure the size of the brush is minimum, and also the opacity of the brush is minimum, and you want to blend that highlight out in a hair like stroke thing. So that is the reason why we are keeping the size of the brush really low. And you guys can go crazy with the highlight thing as I am going here, and I am just adding more highlights on certain parts of the hair, but that's just totally up to you. Now just to touch it up a little bit, I'm just adding more of black, and just here and there, just to create more depth to the hair. And that is it for today's video, you guys. I really hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and if you did, please give this video a big thumbs up. Also do subscribe to my channel, I post every Monday and Thursday. And yeah, I will see you guys the next time.